Welcome to Peoria for the opening round of the NIT as the fans are filing into the Carver Arena for opening round action. It's the Loyola Chicago Ramblers taking on the Bradley Braves as these longtime rivals get set to start a new chapter in the NIT. Let's take a look at the bracket. Indiana State, the number one seed in this side, they're taking on SMU now. Minnesota already a winner over Butler. They will move on to round two. Who will join them? We'll see the winner tonight, and Cincinnati taking on San Francisco later to determine that matchup. Alongside Scott Williams, I'm Jordan Burnfield, and Scott, Malibu Leons is the back-to-back years Defensive Player of the Year in the Missouri Valley Conference.
Yeah, the Dutchman gets it done. He's got 50 steals on the season, just four blocks away from 50 on the year as well. And on the other side of the floor, Braden Norris, absolutely fantastic, 13 all A-10, leads this team in assists and steals. The Ramblers will go the way he goes in this basketball game.
Should be a good one tonight as these two get set to renew their rivalry. The Ramblers coming in from just 3 hours north in Chicago. And away we go in the opening round of the National Invitation Tournament. And Bradley starts with the basketball and Almar Atlas in the freshman. Connor Hickman throws it down low to Darius Hanna, working against Miles Rubin, who set the single season blocks record at Loyola. Misses there, but a foul called on the floor.
Well, I like the fact that the Bradley Braves are trying to go inside and establish an inside presence early in this basketball game. They gave their big man, throw him a bone down there, see if he can eat. He'll do all the dirty work the rest of the game.
So we'll inbound it back to the Bradley Braves, who lost to Drake in the semifinals of the Missouri Valley Conference Tournament in St. Louis. Darius Hanna with nine to shoot, going to work against Rubin again, pulls up for the fadeaway jumper, no good, and the rebound to Philip Alston for Loyola.
We're going to see a heavy dose of defense from both these ball clubs tonight. First team to 70 may win this basketball game.
Definitely two defensive-minded teams. The Ramblers were the number two seed in the Atlantic 10 Conference. They lost in their first game of the quarters as a big block by Leons on Miles Rubin.
That's what Leons does. He comes across from the weak side and just throws everything back out of the paint.
Loyola won a share of the Atlantic 10 Conference Championship in their second year in the league. But Loyola and Bradley have been longtime rivals in renewing this one again tonight. Off the miss, here's Des Watson for Loyola. Sheldon Edwards at the top, feeds inside for Rubin, can't get it to go. Loyola coach Drew Valentine wanted a foul, doesn't get it.
Yeah, a lot of contact underneath, but I like the fact that the officials are going to let these two teams play.
Duke Dean down the floor, all 5'8" of him, but one of the best guards in the Missouri Valley Conference. Out to Connor Hickman, misses the three, but Darius Hanna there for the slam.
Well, you gotta get those extra possessions against good defensive teams, and that's a nice job following that shot right to the rim and slamming it home. Got everybody off their feet here in this arena.
Braden Norris trying to throw it inside and turns it over to Hanna. Taking it coast to coast himself. Foul of the bucket goes.
How about the big man using his wheels in transition? Out there leading the break, says, don't worry about it, guards. You guys run the wing. I'll take it in the middle. And takes it all the way down the floor. Let's go back to this one more time. Pick, roll hard to the front of the basket right there to clean everything up. That's great fundamental basketball there. And then coming back the other direction, little sidestep to his right to get outside the frame of the defender, picks up the hoop in the arm.
So Sheldon Edwards picks up the foul, and Darius Hanna at the free throw line, trying to score the first 5 points of this game. And he does. Scott, this is
for a big man.
And this is fun, too, because you've got two teams that have played each other a lot. This is the 71st all-time meeting, but they have played a lot recently because this is only Loyola's second year in the Atlantic 10, and now they get to meet in the NIT.
Yeah, and I like the fact that all these games are close. 35% of those 70 games decided by five or fewer points.
Off the miss, Darius Hanna with the rebound and out to Duke D. These guys play a lot of close ones. They know each other, certainly. And now a three try is good. That is Christian Davis.
Yeah, that's just Norris doing what he does. A little penetration and pitch. He's wide open to his teammate.
And now Sheldon Edwards, the miss on the three. The rebound to Damon Delacoon. Sends it out to Sheldon Edwards. Misses a three and the rebound to Darius Hanna. What a start for Brad.
It really is a good start. They're controlling their own defensive glass and they're getting on the offensive glass and they're getting open looks from the perimeter.
Davis throws to the corner. Leon's going to work, spins around Norris, 10 straight points for the Bradley Braves.
Oh, I would have been a great pro if I had that spin move. What a move by the young man down there on that block.
You are a great pro, but that's for discussion after a timeout. 16:30 to go here in the first half.
Well, that was a nice little penetration and pitch from Norris, cans the triple. One more time, look at this. Beautiful bucket down on the block. Bradley doing it, 10-0.
The world's largest sports book in Las Vegas is now right at your fingertips here in Illinois. Hi, I'm Derek Stevens. I'm a lifelong sports bettor, and I'm the owner of Circus Sports. We're excited about launching our Circus Sports app in Illinois. It's sports betting the way it should be, with high betting limits, tight money line splits, exceptional customer service, and more. Download your new bookie today at circusports.com. Start betting like a pro from anywhere in Illinois.
The rush to the playoffs. The biggest games. The biggest stage. The Stanley Cup Final returns on ABC and ESPN+.
Nothing. Bradley, the early lead over Loyola Chicago here early in the first half in the opening round of the NIT. Here is sister Jean Dolores Schmidt before the game. She does a pregame customized prayer before every Loyola basketball game. At home, she does it on the floor. On the road, she'll do it for the players in the locker room. But Scott Williams, let me tell you, sister Jean does her homework. She knows the opponent. She's ready to go.
I tell you what, I had a chance. I was walking back and I saw her. She's an international celebrity. I'm not very starstruck very often, but I had to stop and get my photo with Sister Jean. I'll put that one on my gram.
Absolutely. And Sister Jean here tonight and cheering on the Ramblers as she always does. She has been team chaplain for the Loyola basketball program for 3+ decades.
Yeah, I told her. I said, Sister Jean, you may not remember me, but I played with Yeah, I told her, when I got in her ear, I said, I played with Michael Jordan, the Chicago Bulls 30 years ago. She goes, I remember you. She said, if I buy her book, she's going to autograph it for me.
Oh.
So I'm going to get her book, and I'm going to send it to her, and she's going to autograph my copy.
There you go. I think you guys are going to have to trade books.
Yeah, I'll send her
an autographed copy of yours.
That's a good idea.
Yeah, so they're mopping up the floor real quickly, so a brief delay on the floor, but a heck of a start for the Bradley Braves here with a 10-0 lead. And now we return to action. Jalen Quinn on the floor for the first time for Loyola. Damon Delacoon out of the timeout. Whip it around to Quinn, who drives baseline into a double team. Watson now with 9 to shoot. Braden Norris open on the wing for 3. That won't go. Rebounded to Des Watson. Loyola 0 for 6 from the field so far.
Yeah, that Bradley really moving good defensively.
And now Dana Delacoon puts in the first basket for Loyola.
Yeah, that second chance points. Coach is not going to be happy about giving up that extra opportunity. His team is playing so good defensively, controlling their glass.
And now Malibai Leon's outside for 3. Can't get it to go.
But look at the looks that Braves are getting. Wide open. Not anybody within 5 feet of Leon's on that triple.
And Leon's of that length, 6'9", 210, shooting from the arc. And now Jalen Quinn trying to go to work. Stops inside the free throw line, misses the shot, and Leon's the rebound.
Leon's does a good job establishing that position early, blocks it out, controlling that rock.
Try to go inside for Davis. It's stolen by Adelicoon. Down the floor, Des Watson. Can't get it to go.
Yeah, Leon's was right at the rim to challenge that shot. Made Watson change what he wanted to do at the rim.
Now Duke Dean on the drive. Feeds it off. And the bucket good for Connor Linke.
Well, these guards are doing such a nice job getting that ball below the free throw line. It's putting so much pressure on the Loyola's defense. They just can't stay with the Braves.
Des Watson frustrated by Leon's and sends it away. Loyola had some trouble scoring in their last A-10 game when they lost to St. Bonaventure in the second half. And the offensive woes continuing here early as Leon's draws a foul. Right at the end of their game against St. Bonaventure, they were outscored 11-0 to send it to overtime. Brian Wardle, 9th season at Bradley, has done an outstanding job. 2 Arch Madness titles in 2019 and in 20. Of course, 2020, the NCAA tournament was canceled, but in 2019, Bradley nearly knocked off Michigan State in the NCAA tournament.
Yeah, Jordan, I was doing about 90 miles per hour down the 55, trying to get here for practice yesterday, and I'm glad I did because the intensity, of course, Wardle in practice was such a treat to lay my eyes on. He really had his guys out there prepping hard for this game tonight. It is showing here in the first 6 minutes.
You saw Drew Valentine, who already in year 3 at Loyola has his team with a share of the regular season conference crown. After last year, they finished in last. His first year on the job, they won the Missouri Valley Conference. That was their last year in the MVC. They went to the NCAA tournament. Drew Valentine's done a phenomenal job with Loyola. Jalen Quinn trying to get it inside for Miles Rubin, and a foul going to be called on Almar Atlason. Got the body on Miles Rubin as the pass was coming in.
Yeah, you can really see Loyola likes a lot of that pick and roll action, trying to get the players rolling hard to the basket, putting that pressure down underneath the basket.
Inbound goes to Miles Rubin, lost the handle, out of bounds, off of Rubin to Bradley.
Yeah, active hands down there. Big man did the cardinal sin, bringing that ball down below his waistband, where those little guys like to be able to strip it away.
Bradley with all the momentum here early on.
Yeah, and you can see right now Coach Valentine's doing a little three-quarter press, trying to change the rhythm of this Bradley attack.
Marion Birch, the freshman, into the game for the first time. Throws down low, Christian Davis. Works on Rubin, misses off the glass, and the rebound to Miles.
Good defense down there, tough left-hand hook, and then he rebounded that ball cleanly. Look how quick Bradley gets back defensively.
Rubin down low, Austin the bucket and the foul.
Well, that was just a lot of strength underneath there. Rubin got good low post position and fought right through that contact. Look at the entry pass. Right down there inside that restrictive area. Wasn't a whole lot they could do after he got it that deep.
So Philip Alston will go to the line after the foul on Atlason, and now Almar Atlason, the freshman, picking up his second foul here early. Phil Alston, you see third team all A-10 this season, has been such a great find for the Loyola basketball program over the last 2 years for Drew Valentine after transferring in from California of Pennsylvania. Came from the Division II ranks and has been one of the key players for Loyola the last two seasons.
Yeah, look at Loyola's gone back into a little bit of a matchup zone defense. They called back into their man-to-man, but they're really trying to pack in the painted area.
Davis, nice pass down low for Birch.
Yeah, you got to watch Bannon ball. Gave him a nice top opportunity to sneak back door along that baseline, and easy too.
And now it's going back the other way. And a foul on Alston away from the basketball.
Look at that nice backdoor dish right there. Easy 2 points. Bradley is just having their way in the paint early on.
Loyola off to a 2-for-11 start from the field. Connor Hickman leaves it off Hannah. Around Rubin for the cup.
It's just like there's a red carpet down there underneath the Bradley basket, and everybody wants to walk it. They're just doing so much damage underneath. They got to figure out a way to keep Bradley out of the paint.
Nine to shoot for Loyola. Miles Rubin going to work on Hannah. Spins into a double team. 3 seconds to shoot. He traveled.
That is just a swarming defense. Any time they put the ball on the floor, there's a help defender right there waiting on the next move. And you got to give Bradley a lot of credit right now. They're doing a wonderful job playing team defense.
Well, you take a look at Bradley's season summary this year. This Braves team won 22 games. Went 13-7 in the Missouri Valley Conference, losing to Drake in the MVC semifinals, but they are a very good defensive team. They always are. Led the conference in opposing points per game, and they're 19-4 when they get over 70 points.
That's the key number. You mentioned right there, 70 points. Bradley gets 70 points in this game. Turn the lights out on Loyola season.
And a great start in November. They struggled a lot in December and then got hot again as conference season began. Sheldon Edwards coming around a screen. Hauled off and now sends it out. Just 5 points for Loyola. We're almost 9 minutes into the game. Jalen Quinn off of Rubin and out to Leons. Another takeaway for the Braves. Leons coast to coast.
Wow, that was pretty. Leons behind the back all the way right to the rack.
Beautiful move for the fifth-year senior from the Netherlands. And now a foul called. That'll go against Birch, his first for Bradley.
They get swarming defense down here. A lot of hands on that ball, poking away, and Leon does a nice job. Big man handling the basketball. That's Scottie Pippen-ish right there.
On campuses nationwide, the NCAA is making transformative changes for student athletes. While they pursue their biggest dreams, we're launching new initiatives to help them. Life-changing education opportunities are just the start. The NCAA is providing enhanced mental health services. We're guaranteeing scholarships and tuition and expanding access to health care. Visit ncaa.org/change to learn more.
From my lips,
Mielle,
to my ears, real ones know that finding the right products can be a major struggle. But Mielle, fire.
Edges late.
Curls? Pop it.
Frizz? I don't know her.
For wash day, for every day.
And don't even get me started on the smell.
Created by me, for all of you.
Bounce. Amelia, turn off alarm.
Amelia, weather?
70 degrees and sunny today.
Amelia, unlock the door.
I'm afraid I can't do that, Jen.
Why not?
Did you forget something?
My protein shake.
The future isn't scary. Not investing in it is.
You're so dramatic, Amelia.
Bye, Jen.
100 innovative companies, one ETF. Before investing, carefully read and consider fund investment objectives, risks, charges, expenses, and more in prospectus at Invesco.com.
Hurry up and try new Little Caesars Crazy Puffs. They're four fun-sized puffs packed with layers of pepperoni, cheese, and sauce, and only $3.99. So what are you waiting for? Try them now.
You heard him. We need to go try these new Little Caesars Crazy Puffs right now.
Stop it! Drive like the wind, Debbie. Enjoy delicious new Crazy Puffs on the go for just $3.99. Only at Little Caesars.
Pizza, pizza.
The world's largest sports book in Las Vegas is now right at your fingertips here in Illinois. Hi, I'm Derek Stevens. I'm a lifelong sports bettor, and I'm the owner of Circus Sports. We're excited about launching our Circus Sports app in Illinois. It's sports betting the way it should be, with high betting limits, tight money line splits, exceptional customer service, and more. Download your new bookie today at circussports.com. Start betting like a pro from anywhere in Illinois.
Well, last week, Loyola went into the Atlantic 10 tournament as the 2-seed. They were one of the hottest teams in the country, having won 10 of 11. But Darryl Banks III, late in the game, was unstoppable for St. Bonaventure, and Loyola was knocked out of the A-10 tournament in the quarters. They did not get a win. They played one game. They got the double bye, but that was it, 75-74. But that's been kind of the one blemish in recent months. This Loyola team went 23-9, 15-3 in the A-10 to win a share of the regular season title. They were playing great ball. In November and December, it was kind of a slow build for Loyola. They were trying to figure things out after having some guys transfer from last year. But they played great basketball really since their South Florida game, December 16th. And now Damon Delacun will go to the line after they got a third opportunity to score, and the foul coming up against Connor Linke.
Yeah, good job working the glass there, getting those second chance opportunities. But you got to wonder, it's sometimes having a very tough 1-point loss is more damaging to the effective of the psyche than if you just got blown out by 20, because they're really struggling here early on in this game.
Every NCAA Women's Championship game is on the networks of ESPN. For more information, go to NCAA.com, your home for all 90 NCAA championships. Yeah, it's definitely something to think about as Loyola trails 20-6 here early on in this game. The Ramblers, a team that averaged just over 73 points per game. They're a very good defensive team as well. But really what did them in that St. Bonaventure game was they went ice cold from the field in the second half and really couldn't recover. But it's been all Bradley tonight. Connor Hickman, the bucket there.
Yeah, Hickman was one of those guys Coach Valentine really marked as one of their bench players for Bradley that they really got to watch from the outside. But he went right inside and got a bucket.
David Delacun up high. Now Sheldon Edwards trying to feed him down low. Threw that pass too far, and it goes off of Bradley and out of bounds.
Yeah, thank you for his teammate, and they're lucky they retained possession.
So Bradley started the game on a 10-0 run. They've scored 5 points off turnovers. Loyola already with 4 miscues. And the Ramblers, 2 out of 14 from the field. Five to shoot for Loyola. Dez Watson in the corner for 3. That won't go. Tom Welch, the rebound and the putback.
Oh, boy, did they really work the glass on that possession there. Though they're starting to get after him. Not making the initial shot, but kind of like that hockey play where you dump it in under the net, and they just go chasing it, and they put it in the basket.
Now Leon's working against Sheldon Edwards. Spins around him, gets past Welch for the bucket.
Boy, his young man has got one nasty spin move down on that baseline. Twice successful using that spin move to get to the right to the front of the rim.
Well, you said that one where he went behind his back was like Scottie Pippen. What was that one like?
Well, I'll tell you what, Scottie Pippen had some length, and at 6'7", he reminds me of a young Scottie Pippen.
Now inside. Loyola able to get something on the board with Dez Watson.
Yeah, both teams going inside for baskets. I think that's where Loyola's got to live here the remainder of this half. They got to attack the paint.
Here's Duke Dean off target, rebounded to Watson. Dez on the run. Tried to get by Leons, ran out of room. Out to Tom Welch, misses the 3.
I'll tell you what, I wouldn't want to try to attack Leons down there either. Gets off the floor quickly with the long arms.
Duke Dean comes up short again.
Yeah, Dean right now, he's about the only Bradley Brave that's struggling from the outside.
Duke Dean has been a great addition to this Bradley program, transferring it from Troy, where he was Sun Belt Freshman of the Year a couple of years ago. Dean's second on Bradley in scoring this year. He's 5'8", but he plays like he's a lot bigger. Feeds out to Davis, the miss on the 3. And the tip back ends up with Bradley.
Little stoppage of play here. I think the officials want to get together and see if that last one wasn't an over and back, a controlled tip.
We'll take a look back at the Valley when we return. Bradley up 14.
For years, they competed against each other. But every 4 years, they take on the world. They represent our schools and our country. We are proud to say, Olympians are made here.
Are you ready to meet your demise?
Man, we really need to upgrade your trash talk.
Nice shot. Shot. Taker.
Who programmed you?
I'll see you tomorrow.
The future isn't scary. Not investing in it is. 100 innovative companies, one ETF. Before investing carefully, read and consider fund investment objectives, risks, charges, expenses, and more in prospectus at Invesco.com.
Michelob Ultra, superior light beer.
Hurry up and try new Little Caesars Crazy Puffs. They're 4 fun-sized puffs packed with layers of pepperoni, cheese, and sauce, and only $3.99. So what are you waiting for? Try them now.
You heard him. We need to go try these new Little Caesars Crazy Puffs right now.
Stop for it! Drive like the wind, Debbie. Enjoy delicious new Crazy Puffs on the go for just $3.99. Only at Little Caesars.
Pizza, pizza.
Blue skies, open roads, all
all-terrain gear by Wrangler for the ride of life.
Well, having this matchup in the NIT definitely looks back in recent history. Loyola and Bradley were longtime rivals in the Missouri Valley Conference. And in the last five seasons in which Loyola was in the Valley, it was either Loyola or Bradley that won this league. Loyola three times, Bradley two times. You can see it there. Loyola in its final 2 years as members of the Missouri Valley Conference, winning the conference championship and going to the NCAA tournament. So when this matchup got announced Sunday night, Scott, there was no love lost between the fan bases, and this smoldering rivalry, which has gone on for a long time, just got some embers thrown on the fire.
I love it. You know, it's when you get win the last two conference titles and then skip town, so to speak, going to the A-10. You know Bradley wanted to see them here in NIT.
Brian Wardle said before the game that they were trying to focus on this game and not get emotional about the opponent. But he said, I think our fans are emotional about it. And I think you could already see that and feel that in the arena tonight. Yeah, both of these fan bases care.
This building does have an electric feel to it, and a nice stop coming out of that timeout. Coach Valentine's squad, they can ill afford to let Bradley run that score up to 35 or 38 points in this half. They got to do it on the defensive end.
And now a foul coming up. That'll go against Connor Hickman. First personal against the junior from Bloomington, Indiana, who was third team All-MVC this year. It was also on the most improved team in the Valley. And now Jalen Quinn will go to the free throw line, the sophomore from Tuscola, Illinois. First free throw off target. There's Drew Valentine, the head coach of the Ramblers, and you can see Loyola in year number two in the Atlantic 10 shares the regular season conference crown. Last year, they were picked to finish in the top four in the league, really because of their reputation coming out of the Valley. They finished in last place. And what Drew Valentine was able to do to turn this program around, really remarkable in 1 year. There's a three ball, good for Connor Hickman.
Oh, the skip pass, devastating right across the top of the defense. And Hickman just took the lid off that three-point shot in Canyon.
16-point lead for the Bradley Braves, who jumped out to the 10-0 lead and haven't looked back. Patrick Mwamba, the up fake now inside to Miles Rubin for the bucket.
That's a good basketball right there. I talked about how they were going to have to go inside Loyola and get some buckets, get some high percentage shots, because their outside shooting has just been atrocious in the first half. I'll go back to this one more time. Just that little screen there across the top by Hannah, and Hickman knocks it down. And then we go down here, down low. Nice little entry pass underneath there, and get the high percentage shot. So 14-point game, 6:19 to play. Loyola trying to stay in touch.
To shoot now for Bradley. Duke Dean at the top. Dean with two to shoot, with one to shoot, has to put it up, gets it off the glass to go, and a foul.
Well, Duke Dean, a guy I said hadn't been doing anything here in this first half, up against the shot clock, finds a way to get to the free throw line off of that stick, that screen by Hannah, and takes that contact and banged it hard off the glass. You don't see a lot of those go in.
And the foul on Norris to boot. And now the officials coming over to the scorer's table. They want to take another look here. Did he get the shot off before the end of the shot clock? Yes, it appears.
Yeah, I think the ball was halfway to the basket before the red light on the backboard came on. So this should take very long for the officials to sort this one out.
Well, it's sort of a microcosm of the first half, right? That Loyola defends for 30 seconds. They get the bucket at the end of the shot clock, and there's a foul on Braden Norris, who is one of their senior leaders. It didn't even look like he made a lot of contact, frankly, with Dean.
Yeah, this is a nightmarish start for Loyola and their fan base right now, because Bradley seems to be having their way both inside and around the perimeter, getting good looks. Now, that one might have been a bit of a prayer, but you can't foul a guy trying to throw one up there to beat the shot clock.
Dean misses the free throw, and so now Loyola will bring it across down 16. Duke Dean, first team All-Valley this year. Jalen Quinn around Birch, no. Tip back is good for Miles Rubin.
Oh, a couple of hands up there above the rim there. You wonder if that one might have been touched while it was still in the cylinder. The officials missed it.
Davis blocked by Rubin, but a foul called. And Drew Valentine cannot believe it. That'll be the second foul on Miles Rubin. Let's take a look.
Look how long Rubin is. He tries to go up there, and I think he gets the ball cleanly, but is there body contact? Is there any hip on hip? Ooh, I don't know. Didn't seem like there was a whole lot there.
And maybe leading with the elbow at first, but still seemed like minimal contact, but a foul on Rubin. Christian Davis at the free throw line and knocks down the first.
Well, I always say, I tell young players, if you are aggressive taking the ball to the rack and it looked like there could be contact, generally the officials are going to reward the offensive player for being aggressive. So a good teaching point for you young hoopers out there.
Bradley Braves been in the Valley for a very long time. And they've had a great basketball program, a rich tradition and history. Watson down low. Against a double, they have to kick it out. Watson now for a three from the left wing, no.
You see the way Bradley swarms to the basketball when it gets down there below the free throw line.
Now a tie up and a foul called against the Ramblers. And Braden Norris will pick up his second.
Yeah. So Norris trying to fight underneath that pick of Hannah. Just kind of throws his arms around the big fella, maybe trying to bait the officials into making a foul call there on Hannah.
So Darius Hannah will go to the free throw line. And if you're Drew Valentine, what are you telling your guys to try to get something going?
Well, they got to obviously stay with it. They got to fight through this poor shooting half and regroup. Just try to keep close and regroup at halftime and hope that these guys can find their shots in the second half.
Still got almost 5 minutes to go here. Greg Dolan, the drive. Hannah races it out of bounds.
So quickly to close the distance on the weak side, and that's a thing of beauty. This is the way you teach your big guys to come over here and protect that weak side lane right there and swat that one out of bounds. I tell you what, Hannah and Leon, they do a good job protecting that bucket.
Looking like a young Scott Williams out there.
I don't never move that fast. I've blocked a couple shots, but not as many as these dudes.
Miles Rubin will go to the line.
Well, that's one of the things you mentioned, Jordan, is I pride myself on defense, but I am amazed the way athletes can move on the floor nowadays. They can just fly around the court.
Miles Rubin now to the line. He's a guy that's a high flyer with Loyola's blocks record this season. And the first free throw up and too strong. Let's take a look at the National Invitation Tournament bracket. And Indiana State taking on SMU. That game currently on ESPN Plus. Minnesota the win. So they'll play Saturday or Sunday against the winner of ISU-SMU. And then after our game, Cincinnati-San Francisco. Winner of our game will get the winner of the game later tonight. Miles Rubin connects on the second free throw. 5 first half points for the freshman from Chicago.
You can see Coach Valentine telling his guys, push up, push up. They want to take some time off of that shot clock, maybe slow this game down a little bit, see if they can't regroup at halftime with a slower pace here to end the half.
Hickman trying to tell Hannah to set the screen. Atlasson kicks to the corner for Leons. 8 to shoot. Leons against the double, skip pass. Hickman, 3 to shoot, does he know it? 1 second, Hannah's gotta put it up. It goes back to Loyola.
That's just great D right there. Those guys were flying all over the floor. They have not given up on trying to make this a single-digit game here by the break. That's what they got to do. Maybe put a little pressure on Bradley.
As Watson now, fadeaway jumper over Leon's won't go. Nice rebound from Rubin. Another chance for the Ramblers. Alston's got to kick it out. Watson for three. No. Ramblers now 0 for 8 from beyond the arc.
Just frigid in this building for the Ramblers. I like the fact that they're getting some second opportunities, but still got to continue to pump that ball inside.
Well, you made the point earlier that the Ramblers, obviously, they need some stops. Down 15 points. Miles Rubin nearly got it, but flies out of bounds. Drew Valentine has said this year, when we're at our best, we're defending. Duke Dean at his best from beyond the arc and hits a three.
Yeah, that's when Loyola gets in trouble every time Bradley gets the ball below the free throw line with the drop. You know, they're going to the basket for buckets in the paint or they're finding their shooters on the perimeter.
Spin move, Watson, no.
Watson with a big time spin move of his own, but just could not finish.
Now Atlason stepped on the line out of bounds, and it brings us to another timeout on the floor.
Well, right now it has been going the Braves' way and doing a nice job spacing out Loyola and knocking down the open jumpers.
But I'm ready to burn. Super hot fire when I move, better feel that burn. Get up before the sun is up, baby, let's work. Good morning. Ready or not, here I come, let's work. Good morning. Get up before the sun is up, baby, let's work. Baby, let's work.
Experience Tommy John Second Skin.
Why are you here?
To find a place to rent. I know renters when I see them.
Apartments.com. We can help you get into a lovely one-bedroom, two-bedroom. I don't want to presume anything.
Apartments.com. The place to find a place.
Love a good breeze.
Did that flower just talk to me?
Yes. I love those little guys.
Become the elephant.
Having a daddy-daughter day, that's my way to play Nintendo Switch.
Feeling Claritin Clear is like
is she
letting her imagination run wild even though she has allergies? Yeah.
First half, Leons is doing his thing, patrolling the defense with the block shots. He's got three blocks early and been very effective going to the rack, 3 of 4 shooting for 8 points. How do you hold a team to 22% shooting in the first half? Leons.
That's exactly right. And you take a look at the big four for Bradley. This is what makes them go. Hickman, Dean, Leons, and Hannah, they are the majority of the scoring for this team. They do use Christian Davis, as they call him, sort of the sixth starter off the bench. But those big four, when they're rolling, Bradley's rolling, and they're certainly rolling here tonight.
Yeah, they're a tough team to beat. It's a fun team to watch as they play both sides of the court.
Phillip Alston along the baseline, lost the handle. Delacun able to save it underneath, and he stepped on the line.
It is a thing of beauty to watch. Pride myself on the defensive side of the ball and the way Bradley swarms to the basketball when one of their Loyola players puts the ball on the floor is really fun to watch. They create a ton of turnovers. 12.6 turnovers a game is what the Braves force.
Now Connor Hickman had that one knocked out of bounds by Greg Dolan. 13 to shoot for the Braves.
I should mention too that 12.6 turnovers a game is second in the Valley Conference.
This is a Bradley team that for many years under Brian Wardle has prided itself on being that stingy defensive team. Really, every team in this conference, right? It's a conference where if you can't defend, you can't win. And Duke Dean, the fadeaway jumper good along the baseline.
Yeah, Duke Dean's starting to heat up, Jordan. That's bad news for Loyola.
20-point lead for the Bradley Braves.
Look at that double team.
Now the kick out. Dolan for three, in and out. And the rebound, Linky.
Well, that Linky boy, he's all effort. Kid plays with a hard hat and a lunch pail.
Now he hands it back to Dean and sets the screen. Dean in the corner, no. Connor Linky, the senior from St. Charles, who's gotten better and better as his career has gone on and getting good minutes here late in his collegiate career. And now defending Adelicone to the post. Six to shoot. Quinn for three, and finally Loyola hits a three. They're now 1 out of 10. It took them 19 minutes to hit a three.
They really needed that one too. We saw Virginia still struggle last night, 14 points and a half. I was wondering if Loyola was going to be able to beat that mark, but that big three there takes them to 19 points. That gives them a little momentum going to the locker room.
For years, they competed against each other. But every 4 years, they take on the world. They represent our schools and our country. We are proud to say, Olympians are made here.
...36-19, Bradley the lead with 49.4 seconds left in the half, and Brian Wardle talking to Duke Dean and his Bradley starting five about how to go into the locker room with some momentum. See the 71st all-time meeting between these two, Bradley leading it 37-33. In fact, Bradley has won 15 straight games against teams in the state of Illinois. They're 18-3 in their last 21. Want to guess who those three losses are against?
I'm pretty sure we'll see them right now.
Yeah, it's the Loyola Ramblers.
They were out for blood tonight.
They certainly were motivated this evening, and they are looking the part through nearly a half. Five to shoot. That one knocked out of bounds. They'll stay with the Braves as Hickman will inbound with 31.6. on the game clock. Goes into Leons, puts it up over Rubin, no. Rebounded Hannah.
They walked.
And he did.
He got pushed, that's why he walked. There's three Loyola shirts around him, and he got pushed into a travel, but nice job getting on the glass nonetheless. Now they got to get a stop, try to take this lead to the locker room, a 17-point lead to the locker room.
Loyola gets some pressure, able to beat it with the shot clock off. Ten seconds left here in the first half. Braden Norris, a long three for the NIT logo. No. Rebounded Hickman. Hannah at the buzzer. Won't go. Almost got it from half court. And at halftime, the Bradley Braves, the three seed, with a 17-point advantage over the Loyola Chicago Ramblers. It has been all Bradley from the get-go. They got off to a 10-0 start. They haven't looked back. Bradley has held Loyola to 7 of 30 from the field.
The Bush Guide, cold and smooth survival skills.
36 to 19, Bradley the lead over Loyola Chicago as we welcome you inside Carver Arena. Alongside former NBA vet Scott Williams, I am Jordan Burnfield. Thanks so much for joining us. And we're in the opening round of the NIT here, Scott. And even though it is the second tournament for some of these guys, I think it's a huge opportunity. And for both of these schools, I think for Loyola and for Bradley, there's so much pride in trying to win this very historic event.
Yeah, it's March. And that's when you're a basketball player. That's who you want to be playing in March in the postseason. And right now, Bradley's really taking it to them. Loyola's got to find their game in the locker room, and I think that they will.
They absolutely have taken a great deal of momentum into the first half tonight. And Bradley is the team that in this field has the most NIT wins of anyone. They are four-time NIT champions at 57, 60, 60, and 64, and 82. In fact, at the top of Carver Arena here, you can see all the times in which the Braves have reached the NIT. And hey, when you win the NIT a long time ago, it means you get to meet the president. That's pretty good when they got to meet President Ronald Reagan. And so for Bradley, this has been something that's so important to them. I mean, Brian Wirtle talked about it with us before the game. He said, listen, we want to go out and win this thing. This means a lot to us. This is about hanging banners.
It really is. And you could tell when I got to practice yesterday, the intensity that these guys have. They want to go out there and add to that 157 NIT victories.
Absolutely. And so now let's take a look at the bracket in the NIT for this year. And we take a look at our upper left quadrant. And Seton Hall and St. Joseph's currently on ESPN2. North Texas already a win. And Boston College a win over Providence. And then how about Princeton taking on UNLV?
Yeah, Princeton's a team I'm really watching. They've been averaging 93 points per game in their last two basketball games.
Princeton last year, obviously a great run in the NCAA tournament. Bottom left of the bracket, I know that you've got your eye on that Wake Forest App State game.
Yeah, App State always gives teams in North Carolina in the ACC trouble. I'll tell you what, Wake Forest has got Silas. He's going for 18 a game. He's going to need it all tonight.
Take a look at our next quadrant of the tournament. And on the top right, that's our side of the bracket here. Indiana State taking on SMU. Currently on ESPN+. And after our game tonight, it'll be Cincinnati and San Francisco. That's a really compelling matchup.
Yeah, Cincinnati's so good on the defensive side of the ball.
Certainly, Jizzle James, one of the great players to watch in this tournament. And finally, at the bottom right, you take a look at this side of the bracket. Iowa, a very impressive win last night against Kansas State.
Yeah, they look like they are motivated to go out there and try to take the title. They were good on both sides of the basketball, especially spreading out Kansas State and getting some good looks. They lit up the scoreboard with those 91 points.
Well, what does it all lead to? This place, Hinkle Fieldhouse in Indianapolis. That's where our NIT semifinals and championship will be. Of course, it opened in 1928, and if you've never been, you have to go if you're a college basketball fan. Hoosiers was filmed there in 1986, but truly one of the great cathedrals in college basketball. We're here in Peoria. It's all Bradley at halftime. Second half is coming up.
Question. Student body math proficiency.
What?
What do we say? It's good, fair.
Hey, get out of here, man.
Understood.
Security. Hey, excuse me. We get you real in-depth school info.
Ding dong.
Homes.com.
My favorite babysitter is Annalisa.
She's pretty good. She's like my grandma.
She says, hola, ¿cómo estás?
She plays with me.
She helps you feel better.
Bugs and insects are healthy for you.
Amelia took us to the beach.
She teaches me some gymnastics. We like color.
We draw flowers.
And then we go skateboarding.
From babysitters to nannies to daycare centers, find all the care you need at care.com.
The rush to the playoffs. The biggest games. The biggest stage. The Stanley Cup Final returns on ABC and ESPN+.
19, Bradley the lead, 36-19, the lead for Bradley over Loyola as we get set for the start of the second half. And the Bradley Braves had everything working in the first half of play, Scott.
Yeah, they did a really good job spacing out Loyola. I love this play right here. You get a skip pass over to the corner, freeze it right there. Once you get this penetration to the middle, the defender's got to suck to the level of the ball, leaves wide open shot out here on the perimeter for one of the three three-point shots that knocked down.
Christian Davis knocking down the three, and in the first half of play, Loyola shot just 23% from the field. Bradley shot 50%, and Loyola, and this is one of the big problems for the Ramblers in the first half, and Bradley's defense was great, Scott, but Loyola was 1-for-11 from three and 23% from the field. You just can't get anything going if you can't get a shot to fall.
Well, and the other thing, they had those rim protectors down there, five block shots, most of those in the paint. Obviously makes it real tough sledding in there, but I love the points in the paint. A plus six advantage for Bradley going inside.
And so you take a look at Bradley's big four. Those are the guys that really have to be going for Bradley to have success. Balanced scoring in the first 20 minutes, and one of the reasons they've got this commanding 17-point lead. What are you looking for here early from Loyola in the second half? They're going to need that from Braden Norris.
Well, yes, hitting some threes, obviously, and knocking down some shots. They got a rebound there, defensive glass well, trying to get out in transition and score.
Now Darius Hanna, the Thunder Slam. He's left wide open underneath.
That's not going to make Coach Valentine happy. 20 points in the paint now, and that's the easiest, too. Hanna's had all season.
Now Alston on the wing, way short on that three try. Down the court quickly, Hanna blocked by Alston, but they're going to call the goaltend.
Yeah, you nailed it, Jordan. Nice job of Hanna getting out and running in transition for a big man. He is very mobile. I thought he was going to dunk that one. Look at this one more time. He kind of nonchalants it a little bit. And gives a defender a chance to come over and block that one away, but easily you can tell that the ball is on its way back down into the cylinder right there before the contact is made.
So there you go, the goaltend against the Ramblers, and Darius Hanna into double figures now with 11 points tonight.
Yeah, Hanna got him started with those quick seven early on. It's been steady defensively.
Jalen Quinn, no, underneath. It's rebounded by Malavi Leons.
Now Leons is doing his thing tonight, getting on the glass. He's scoring inside, and he's blocking shots. Is just one block shot away from 50 on the season.
Back-to-back 50 block seasons. Oh, there's a big block from Miles Rubin.
Rubin the eraser, 2.6 blocks a game.
And there's the block for Leon.
That's it right there. 50 blocks now to go along with those 50 steals. We're having a block party up in here, Jordan. Look at this one more time by Rubin. He says, I close on you, and then coming back the other way, the big shot blocker for Bradley says, okay, I'll match that down here on this end.
Did you have a production meeting with Malibai during halftime that I wasn't aware about? You mentioned that he was going for 50 blocks, and then 3 seconds later, he gets the block.
Hey, listen, I was at practice yesterday. I watched this kid move. I was 100% sure he was going to get his 4 blocks tonight.
Well done, sir. That's 4 blocks tonight for Leonz, and now he's got 50 for the year. And now Atlason with the push on Watson, and Atlason picks up an early third foul. He picked up 2 in the first half, which kept him off the floor for much of that first 20. Yeah. And now he goes to the bench here for Davis.
Tough matchup for him out of the perimeter, having to go up against Watson. He's cat quick, and he did the right thing, though. Not every foul's a bad foul.
The inbound goes to Alston for the dunk, and now they're going to call the technical for the hanging on the rim.
Well, I don't know if it's the hanging on the rim or pushing the defender away after the play. Let's see one more time and see if this is a little push
at the end.
Yeah, a little push right up against the neck. But I understand what he was kind of thinking. He's up underneath me. I don't want to land on him. But the push was probably a little bit too demonstrative and did not need to be as aggressive with the push.
And that's huge because Philip Alston is such a key member of this Rambler team. So for him to get called for that foul, that's going to be 3 against him. And now you got Duke Dean to the free throw line.
Yeah, you can see right there up underneath. And see the, it's the right hand on the back of the neck, I think, is what makes the officials have to make that call.
I understand the need for the call, but I think you made a good point, which is to say that I think what Alston's saying is, listen, I don't want to fall on him.
Right.
So I'm trying to get him out of the way.
I'm trying to protect myself, and I'm trying to protect him. But, like I said, then again, there was some intention behind the shot to the back of the head.
And so Duke Dean makes the free throws. They're not booing. They are duking. This is a different kind of Duke. It's okay, Scott. Don't worry.
We're going to talk about your final 4 picks later on in the show tonight, too. I'm real happy with you, partner.
You'll see what we're talking about. Trust me. Here's Darius Hanna. Stop the dribble. Has to find somewhere to go with the ball, and now we'll throw it to Davis at the top. Guarded tightly by Sheldon Edwards. 8 seconds to shoot. Hickman into the paint. Bucket and the foul over Rubin.
Oh, when it's your night, it is your night. What a nice little, I'm going to give it to you and go back door. You give it back to me. Love that right there. Catch the defender napping. And before Rubin can come over and try to change or block that shot, just get that body contact. Real crafty play underneath.
Connor Hickman, 7 points. He's got a couple of rebounds, a couple of assists tonight, make it 8.
Well, this is definitely not the start to the second half Loyola wanted or needed. This place is engaged, it's live, it's rocking. You can see the bounce in the Bradley defender step right here. I got Leon's tangling up underneath there with the hold on the cross cut to the block.
21 is the largest lead for Bradley. It was 17 at halftime. You said it. Loyola had to do something in these first few minutes just to try to cut into what has been a large lead from the get-go tonight.
Yeah, hey, listen, there's still a ton of time left in this game, over 17 and a half to play, and they got to start chipping away, right? They got to figure out a way, get this thing down to 15, try to get it down to 10, and then see if you can't get it to single digits at around that 5-4-3 minute mark, and just see, hey, maybe after having such a large lead, maybe Bradley tightens up a little bit. You give yourself a chance to try to steal one in the final seconds of the game.
Norris coming around the curl, hits a 3. He's hit 2 here in the second half.
Well, they worked real hard at the shootaround on their baseline out of bounds plays, and it paid dividends on that possession.
And now Greg Dolan picks up the foul on the other end.
Hey, look at it one more time. Just a double screen there, freeing the shooter, knocking it down. Bench loved it. Well, if I know this Coach Valentine's coach team, they are not going to give up regardless of what the scoreboard says. They're going to keep playing hard to the final horn.
Here's Duke Dean. This is the three there. Rebound Olston.
Fans think that Olston got away with a little high dribble here along the sideline.
Might have a point. Here's Delacoon. Goes to the top. Norris passes on the three. Drives the lane for the bucket.
Son of a coach. Knows what he's got to do there. That little swing, swing. No hesitation. Not shooting this three ball. I'm going to take it right to the rack.
Well, they can really use the offense from Braden Norris. Now 8 points on the second half. Hickman, a foul before the shot.
He stepped out of bounds. He stepped out of bounds. Oh, yeah. Boy. Loyola gets the stop they need.
Well, Bradley with a 45-29 lead here in the second half. And along the water, here in beautiful Peoria, the Bradley Braves are rolling.
Point lead for Bradley here. The big reason why is Darius Hanna. He is absolutely balling out tonight. Got a game high 11 points, doing his damage inside, 24 points in the paint. And I love that follow slam right there. That's the only second chance points that Bradley has tonight. Did you know that? That came early in the game.
Yeah, and it's been such a clean game for Bradley tonight. They've shot almost 52% from the field. It's not like they've needed a ton of second chance opportunities here, and they've been up by so much for most of the game.
Yeah, well, I'll tell you, Loyola right now on a little 5-0 spurt, cutting into that large 21-point deficit. They got it down to 16, but then they turn it over.
Yeah, trying to throw it out to Edwards. Turns it over.
That's what Bradley was so good at in that first half, swarming to that basketball, and the offensive player picks up that dribble. You got a couple white shirts around it. Ball every time.
Linking, trying to lead Hickman down the lane. It's taken away. Braden Norris with a head of steam. Finding Sheldon Edwards. Misses the three. Tipped around, and it gets to Adelakun for Loyola. Telekun nearly turns it over, and now he does. Trying to save it, Birch took it away. And now Birch misses the shot and the rebound, Alston.
Well, back-to-back turnovers by Loyola, but they're lucky because Bradley was not able to score on either of those possessions.
Kicked by Davis. So it'll remain Loyola basketball. Just the last two possessions, though, it feels like even though Loyola didn't score there, they seem to have a little bit more of a momentum that they're trying to build.
Offense looks better, right? Like,
yes.
It just seems like Loyola is almost fighting themselves to try to score points.
Alston down the lane against Linky. No, Adelacun, yes.
Oh, that's what you need. They got 10, make it 12 now. Second chance points. And again, cutting it to 14. We talked about them trying to get it to 10, and there's still a ton of time left in this game. 15 minutes to play.
Birch against Dolan. And now Linky with 9 to shoot. Stop the dribble. Hickman with 4 to shoot, with 3. Inside, Linky's open. Oh, what a block from Alston. Dolan now quickly the other way. Adelacun to the post against Leons. Kick out, Greg Dolan misses the 3, and Alston grabs the rebound.
Suddenly, Bradley cannot rebound their own defensive glass.
Adelacun spins around Leons, and a foul call.
Go back in the other way. What you thought was a sure two, all of a sudden, the weak side block. You shall not pass. Oh, that's a thing of beauty. I love when those guys get up off the floor and protect the basket.
Great block from Philip Alston. And the Ramblers, who are down 21, trying to chip away here. As Adelacun knocks down the free throw. You know, the hard part when you're down by so much, Scott, is you want to get it all back, but you can't get it back right away. You got to just keep trying to get stops, get another basket, try to get stops. And for some teams, that's a very hard mentality to adapt over a long stretch of time.
Yeah, but Coach Valentine's doing a good job coaching him up. He hadn't sat down all night. He is working his guys and continue to fight. Once a 20-point lead down to 12, and you can start to see that Bradley's tightening up a little bit. Even though a 12-point lead is huge, when you're up by 21, now it seems like you're on the struggle bus when you're really still in control of the game.
That's
but
right.
Psychologically, it makes a big difference for Loyola to say, hey, we're right there. We can steal this game.
9-0 over the last 3, 12. Out of bounds, it'll stay with Bradley, 14 to shoot. Duke Dean met by Dolan up at the Bradley logo. 5 to shoot. Now 3, Dean. No, Leons the rebound, stripped from him, but a foul.
Well, Leons, right? Dean, these goes, you need a bucket, you go to two of your superstars, and Leons getting on that glass for his 7th rebound, and a big time for an offensive board. He goes back up strong, and now he's gonna have an opportunity to go to the line and shoot too. And that's what Bradley desperately needed. They needed to get somebody to score inside or get to that free throw line to get some points to stop the bleed.
Braden Norris picked up his 3rd foul. Malibu Leons at the line and knocks down the first. Well, every NCAA Women's Championship game is on the networks of ESPN. For more information, go to NCAA.com, your home for all 90 NCAA championships. Malibu Leons knocks down both free throws.
Yeah, it's hard to say that those are pressure free throws when you're up by 12 with 14 minutes to play, but those were pressure free throws. They needed to score some buckets, and Leons delivered.
Well, you don't want to start getting it down to 10, down to 8, down to 6. Then you're really thinking this is a different game.
Exactly. And I tell you what, right now, the way Loyola is moving the ball around on this offensive end, Bradley's going to be hard to stop them here on this possession. Ooh, got away with a walk.
And he walked.
Oh, he got it. Yeah, he called it travel.
Yep. So it's now a 14-point lead for Bradley with proud NIT history. The Braves trying to hang another banner.
To me, my X-Men.
Now streaming. Only on Disney Plus.
Heads up!
Don't miss the all-new X-Men 97. Now streaming only on Disney Plus.
From the number one rated brand in cordless outdoor power, the Ego Power Plus Blower. Reaching an incredible 765 CFM. And it runs up to 90 minutes on a single charge. Exclusively at Lowe's, Ace, and Ego authorized dealers.
Ladies and gentlemen, let me introduce me.
Which you do you want to be today? At TJ Maxx, you can afford to turn your closet into a place of endless expression. With the quality you deserve, styles you crave, and prices you love.
I'm gonna do what I do.
Maxx, what makes you, you.
Do what I do.
How am I gonna find a doctor when I'm hallucinating? What do you think, Fever Monster?
What about ZocDoc?
ZocDoc?
Dr. Castell has a great bedside manner.
So many options.
But Dr. She-Chan will take your sketchy insurance. She-Chan.
She-Chan. She-Chan. She-Chan.
Thanks, bro.
You've got more options than you know. Book now.
The world's largest sports book in Las Vegas is now right at your fingertips in Illinois. It's sports betting the way it should be, with high betting limits, tight money line splits. Start betting like a pro from anywhere in Illinois.
I'm on the next level now. Oh, to finish.
Is not going down without a fight. The fifth-year senior is knocking down shots here in the second half. He's come off that locker room just firing. Really doing a nice job attacking that basket. He's got 5 points on 2 of 4 shooting. He's gone almost 20 minutes in this basketball game trying to cut into that large deficit.
Braden Norris, nothing in the first half. 8 second-half points for the Loyola Chicago Ramblers. Braden Norris has had a brilliant career for Loyola, has set their record for starts, 127 as a Loyola Rambler. He is now 4 3-point shots away from the all-time school record of 262. Now, this is a guy who is an all-time great Loyola player. And in talking to Drew Valentine, you know, that's one of the things you don't think about in these tournament settings. They're one and dones, but great careers can come to an end in a flash.
Oh, nice job, kick to the free throw line, knock it down, a little mini from the line there.
Back to a 16-point game.
Yeah, Connor Hickman, that was Duke Dean knocking that shot down. So 16-point game, and Loyola's got to figure out a way to get another bucket here.
Norris misses that three, grabbed his own rebound on the long carom. Now Greg Dolan on the drive. Alston goes to work in on Hannah, scores off the glass.
Well, Alston just put that shoulder down and took it right to the chest of the shot blocker. Was able to use the glass to soften the shot after the power move.
Hannah trying to get out of the double. It's taken away by the Ramblers. Des Watson gets it across midcourt and slows it down. Braden Norris uncorks, knocks down another three. Norris now with 11 all in the second half, and now it's an 11-point game. And a timeout for Brian Wardle.
Yeah, that's good transition right there. You get the steal, You get the ball from side to side, and Norris, that was from where Steph Curry and the boys like to shoot it from at the next level. That was a deep three.
Well, Brayden Norris stepping up in a big moment where Loyola absolutely needs him. A long three, 11 points now, 4 of 7 from the field, 3 of 6 from three.
A lot of time left in this game. We talked about that when they were down by 21, right? You get it to 10. I was saying at the 5-minute mark, hey, they're only a point away from getting it to 10 at the 12-minute mark. So a lot of basketball to play. We'll see if Bradley can weather the storm.
Take a look at Loyola's record by month this season, because the way they started the year, you weren't going to expect, frankly, that the Ramblers would end up with a share of the regular season crowd in the Atlanta 10. They were 4-3 in November, 4-2 in December. Really, after the South Florida game, this Rambler team became a different team. The numbers changed for them, and their Kent Pom and their net were in the 80s and 90s at the end of the year. But from December, mid-December on, they were in the 50s. I mean, this was a team that was playing NCAA tournament caliber basketball. In January and February, they were red hot. They went into the month of March red hot, but you said it earlier, you know, they had struggles offensively in that Atlantic 10 quarterfinal game against St. Bonaventure. And for a lot of this game, they've had the same struggles. But can they find a way in the second half to flip the script?
Well, that's it, right? You thought they were up 15 in the first half. 9 at the break against the Bonnies. They're thinking they're going to cruise right to the semifinals. And then all of a sudden, they find themselves going to overtime. They lose in double overtime. Their psyche was shattered to start this game tonight. It has taken them a full 20 minutes to get back to playing Rambler basketball, and now you can see the intensity's picked up on both sides of the floor. They think that they could still, with 12 minutes to play, kind of way to win this basketball game.
Take a look at Bradley on the other side. They went 13-7 in a very good Missouri Valley Conference this year, and now a foul against Philip Alston.
Leon's twice now, when his team has needed him to get on the offensive glass, he has gotten two huge second extra possessions. And now this time they're going to work on their little baseline out of bounds play.
Well, that foul on Alston was his fourth, so he has to come out of the game now for Drew Valentine. And that is a big loss for the Ramblers, one of their key players, with 12 minutes to go. Connor Hickman got by Dolan, gets by Rubin, can't finish underneath.
Well, Rubin was there to change that shot. He didn't block it, but he's certain his presence there changed it enough that Hickman couldn't put it where he wanted to on the glass.
Norris, no, Rubin the tip back.
Wow, this is impressive. This Loyola team is all heart, toughness, and grit. They are fighting back.
10-point game after it was 21 earlier in the second half.
A little too much body along the baseline there. It's going to send a foul on Leon's. But look at this one more time. He didn't get it, but look at the long arms there. Just rebounding outside of his position there and then guiding that one back into the basket there. Rubin's doing a nice job trying to help his team stay in touch here. They got it down to 10.
Foul on Dolan. That is the third on Greg, and now Darius Hanna will go to the line.
And Hanna's been good in this game. We talked about his 11 points that he's had here. Now he's got to knock through this front of this 1-1.
He does. Darius Hanna, a guy that used to come off the bench for the Bradley Braves, has earned more playing time every year, as he has been in Brian Wardle's program this year, named to the Missouri Valley Conference Most Improved Team, and calmly knocks down a couple free throws to extend the lead back to 12.
That big man's got a real nice stroke from the free throw line. The crowd is rising to their feet, realizing their team needs a help on the defensive side of the ball here.
There's Norris. Rubin. And an offensive foul on Miles Rubin. And it brings us to a timeout on the floor with Bradley up 12. Under 11 minutes to go in the opening round of the NIT.
For years, they competed against each other. But every 4 years, they take on the world. They represent our schools.
and our country, we are proud to say Olympians are made here.
And Doug.
Hello, Ghostbusters. It's Doug of Doug and Limu. We help people customize and save hundreds on car insurance with Liberty Mutual. Anyway, we got a bit of a situation here. Sure, I can hold. Only pay for what you need.
Liberty, 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 liberty.
Ghostbusters Frozen Empire, in theaters March 22nd.
Oh, Louie, where are you going?
I gotta handle something.
Nada, yada, yada.
Let's go, Louie, hold on tight, buddy!
Vamos, vamos!
Tired of yada, yada, like exploding bells?
Hey, I'm done with this yada, yada.
You don't take yada, yada in life?
I'll get the paperwork.
Don't take yada, yada from your wireless provider. At Metro, there's no contracts, no exploding bills, and nada, yada, yada.
Michelob Ultra, superior light beer.
The world's largest sports book in Las Vegas is now right at your fingertips here in Illinois. Hi, I'm Derek Stevens. I'm a lifelong sports bettor, and I'm the owner of Circus Sports. We're excited about launching our Circus Sports app in Illinois. It's sports betting the way it should be, with high betting limits, tight money line splits, exceptional customer service, and more. Download your new bookie today at circussports.com. Start betting like a pro from anywhere in Illinois.
There were 17 teams that declined their invitation to this tournament this year. And one of them not in the Power Six. That was St. Bonaventure, a member of the Atlantic 10, just like Loyola. But Scott, I have trouble understanding why all these teams decided they wouldn't go. Sister Jean said, hey, we're coming. We're here. We're ready to play Bradley and drive 3 hours south.
Yeah, I can't for the life of me figure out why Arizona State, the 11th seed there in the Pac-12, the last year of that conference, they lost their last three games by a combined average of 15 points. Why they wouldn't want to get that bad taste out of their mouth. They should be playing basketball right now.
Brayden Norris feeds it up for Edwards. It gets knocked away, but the Ramblers managed to keep it. Now into the paint, Patrick Mwamba.
Oh, nice execution of the jump stop finish underneath. Got ourselves a 10-point game again, 10 and a half to play.
Darius handed the kick. Malavai Leons wide open, misses the three.
His shots are starting to tighten up. When you're up by 20, the basket's as big as a hula hoop. Now all of a sudden you're up 10 and things starts to shrink down, size of a Cheerio.
Can't imagine shooting at a Cheerio. That would be tough, gotta tell you. Brayden Norris kick out. Here's Mwamba, passes up the three. Lost his footing, but Adelakun able to keep it. And now Dame into the lane and puts it off the window. It's a single digit game.
Oh wow, those Loyola Ramblers are a tough bunch. They are going inside for hard fought baskets. They are devastating inside points in the paint.
Turnover by Bradley. Duke Dean turns it over and the Ramblers can cut into it even more.
Well, the momentum, Mo as we call it, has swung violently over here to the right side of the floor and with the Loyola Ramblers, and Bradley right now is leaking oil. They gotta figure out a way to get some stops.
Going back to Bradley with 11 to shoot. They turn it over as that was on the baseline.
Well, we were kind of screened out by Coach Ballantyne, who's been off that bench all night long, and a lot of players down there. I'm not sure if he got kicked, if that was the violation, or if he got bounced on the sideline.
I think he bounced off the baseline.
Okay, bounced on the baseline. And anyway,
but Ballas yes.
got the ball back here. And he got to figure out a way to get the ball either in the paint or off to the free throw line.
Well, Drew Ballantyne was setting the screen on us. There's no question.
Yes, indeed.
A very good high ball screen. And now Hickman, step back jumper is good.
Oh, they needed a bucket, and Hickman does a nice job working the left side of the floor for a big deuce. Place is getting loud. The sixth man is off their seat.
Norris finding Quinn. Kick to the corner, now back up. Harris Quinn knocks down a three. It's a 7-point game.
Well, I love that movement. Swing it side to side, catch the defense slow in rotation.
Hickman trying to take advantage and get down the floor, but the Ramblers scramble back on defense. And now a foul away from the ball.
Get it one more time. Just that little penetration there and that pitch. So devastated. Anytime you drive that ball towards the paint, especially when the ball's down underneath that free throw line, defense has got to collapse. We've been taught since grade school. Drop to the level of the ball, leaves the shooters wide open on the perimeter.
Braden Norris just picked up his fourth foul. That is a huge fourth foul against Braden Norris. For Loyola with 8:25 to go. Alston and Norris both with four fouls, which is something certainly Loyola can ill afford down seven, but yet here they come.
Yeah, look at Bradley come back with a little bit of a zone defense here, trying to give Loyola a different look on this possession.
Angelico underneath Mwamba. Tries to move around Lyons and does.
Wow, nice interior passing in a beautiful move along the baseline. We got ourselves a 2-possession game.
5-point game after it was a 21-point lead for Bradley early in the second half. Birch with the turnover. Here comes Mwamba down the floor to Watson. And now a foul coming up with 7:36 to go here in Peoria. The Loyola fans that made the trek down, they're dancing, they've got their scarves on, and they're down five.
A national taste test determined America's favorite boneless wings. Applebee's won. How about that? We don't even have wing in our name. Get them now for just 50 cents. Only at Applebee's.
So I can take all these trips because Priceline has all these amazing deals.
Look, the deals are hatching.
And that's when I said, deal.
And on your right is our infinity deal pool.
Oh dear, listen.
Breathe in. You are the deals.
I am the deals. The deals are me.
Wait, you can hear me?
Go to your happy price, Priceline.
From friends coming over to moms coming over. So many ways to save. Life ready, wallet happy. That's 365 by Whole Foods Market.
The world's largest sports book in Las Vegas is now right at your fingertips here in Illinois. Hi, I'm Derek Stevens. I'm a lifelong sports bettor, and I'm the owner of Circus Sports. We're excited about launching our Circus Sports app in Illinois. It's sports betting the way it should be, with high betting limits, tight money line splits, exceptional customer service, and more. Download your new bookie today at circussports.com. Start betting like a pro from anywhere in Illinois.
Why are you here?
To find a place to rent. I know renters when I see them.
Apartments.com. We can help you get into a lovely one-bedroom, two-bedroom. I don't want to presume anything.
Apartments.com. The place to find a place.
I'm on the next level now. To finish.
My favorite babysitter is Annalisa.
She's pretty good. She's like my grandma.
She says, hola, ¿cómo estás?
And then we go skate.
boarding.
From babysitters to nannies to daycare centers, find all the care you need at care.com.
But Loyola is pummeling them with body blows inside and headshots out on the perimeter. They're doing a very nice job attacking the interior. The last 5 minutes, 7 of 8 field goals. Taking it ball hard to the basket. BU on the other side, just 1 of 3 with 3 turnovers. But love this one along the baseline there. Hard fought bucket underneath.
And Loyola on a 9-2 run with Des Watson going to the free throw line. And the winner tonight is going to take on the winner of San Francisco and Cincinnati. That game from Fifth Third Arena in Cincy coming up 9 Eastern time on ESPN+. So we'll be watching that game closely tonight to see who the winner of this one will play in the next round of the NIT. If you just saw the first half of play and you turn back and you're going, what happened? It has been two completely different halves of basketball.
Well, we were commenting off air that we thought that Loyola might.
And now Delacuna is fouled, so 2 missed free throws. They get the rebound, they'll go back to the line, and the foul on Davis.
I really thought Bradley outworked Loyola in that first half and did whatever they wanted. But in the second half, like you said, it has been Loyola that has been outworking Bradley here in the second half, and haven't had an opportunity to cut this to a single possession basketball game.
So Damon Delacuna now to the free throw line, and he misses, so that's 3 consecutive missed free throws for Loyola. It's not like they can afford to miss any of these. Second one coming for the Ramblers. And Adelicone makes the second. So they got the second opportunity, but they went 1 of 4 at the line.
Well, we were saying, we were talking off air at halftime that Loyola was going to need 45 points. They have to, in the second half, to want any chance to win. But with only 19 at the first half, it didn't seem like a real possibility. But boy, are they closing on that now. They got themselves 33 points here in this second half.
26-9 run. You just saw it. And now Hannah misses the jumper, and the Ramblers can make it a 1 possession game. Jalen Quinn at the Bradley logo. Under 7 minutes to go in round 1 of the NIT. Damon Delacuna into the paint against the double and kicks it out. Now 6 to shoot. Delacuna again trying to muscle it inside. Lost the handle to Davis. Hickman threw it too fast for Hannah. Ramblers with an opportunity. Watson the Euro step. And a goaltending is going to be called. And the basket good for Loyola. 2-point game.
Well, getting the turnover and then getting out and running in transition. And Watson does a nice job with the Euro step. And you can see that ball was clearly off of the backboard before Leon's came over and tried to swat that one away. So you said we got ourselves a 2-point game. And Bradley is struggling to find the range offensively.
28-9 run. Unbelievable turnaround for Loyola Chicago. Down by 2. Davis, the skip pass and out of Dean. A 3 is good.
Oh, where would they be without Dean's 3s tonight? Knocking down his 3rd triple of the game.
Jalen Quinn now out to Des Watson. Tries to answer with a 3, can't get it to go.
I don't think there's a fan sitting down in this building.
Dean now out to Davis. Connor Hickman, a 3 over Watson. Bank won't go. Rubin the rebound, and Loyola slows it down, down 5. And a timeout taken by Jalen Quinn and the Ramblers with 5:29 to go.
I think Coach Valentine realizes teams playing so hard when you're trying to fight back from a 21-point deficit. It takes you a lot of energy, so he wants to give his team a quick breather.
5-point Bradley lead, 5:29 left, 30-second timeout. Stay with us.
Want to get the most out of one sheep? Grab Bounty. Bounty is made to be stronger and more absorbent. So while ordinary brands can't hold up, one sheet of Bounty keeps working even when wet. Now that's the sound of value. Bounty, the quicker picker-upper.
5-point Bradley lead with 5:29 to go. Bradley led by 17 at halftime. They were up 21, 45-24 with 17:36 left in the second half. So it's not like
cruising.
Loyola started the second half in good shape, and now it's a 28-12 run, and now it's a 5-point game.
Yeah, Bradley was cruising. It looked like they were going to blow the doors right off. But, boy, a lot of fight in this Ramblers squad.
Phillip Alston driving into the paint. Can't get it to go. It's knocked away by Bradley. And the Braves with an opportunity here.
I think Leon's got over there and got his fifth block of the game.
See if they give him credit for that block. And now Davis goes down low for Linky. Almost stolen. And now Dean hoists a three. Too strong. Rebound in Leon's. Alston's got to be careful. He has four. Is that the fifth foul?
Might be.
No, it's going to be Reuben.
Leon's has got three huge offensive rebounds here in the second half, trying to keep Bradley with this lead. And now he'll have an opportunity to go to the free throw line as Bradley is in the bonus.
By the way, you are right. It was the fifth block for Leon's.
And he knocked down the free throw. There's some big bodies in front of us sometimes on this sideline. It's kind of hard to see the action.
Alibi Leon's over 50 blocks now. 51 this season. He is a stat machine. 53 steals as well. Back-to-back seasons with 50 blocks and 50 steals.
And boy, is he good from that free throw line. He's knocked down four big free throws here in this second half. We're back to a 7-point game with under 5 minutes to play. Loving this game.
This rivalry always produces. Steal by Davis. Trying to beat Edwards to the basket. No. Rebound. Putback is good for Connor Hickman.
Oh, they could ill afford a turnover and a transition bucket. The lead has grown back up to 9.
Dolan trying to get around Dean in a foul call on Duke.
Look at this one more time. Just getting in that passing lane, taking that ball to the other. And I love the fight to the basket because it puts so much pressure on the defender. You got teammates running with you to follow it up.
And now Greg Dolan to the free throw line. And he knocks down the first. Dolan, first point of the game. Grad senior from Williamsville, New York, who came to Loyola from Cornell, where he was second team all Ivy League a year ago, finishing his career with the Ramblers in Chicago. And Dolan knocks down both.
Yeah, cool is the other side of the pillow right there after a couple misses from the line. They've lost three opportunities on that free throw line, and get both of those was huge.
Under 4 minutes to go in round one of the NIT.
Well, Bradley obviously trying to melt a little of this clock.
And Leon's is fouled with 6 on the shot clock. And a foul against Dame Adelakun, his second. We'll make our final 4 picks. I don't think Scott's gonna like mine.
0. Zero sugar hydration with all the flavor and electrolytes of Gatorade. Hydration for every athlete, forever.
Rash? Maybe it'll go away. Oh, how am I gonna find a doctor I'll feel comfortable showing this to? A QR code? Okay. Oh, all these great doctors are on ZocDoc. Dr. Taylor's a great listener. Meh. Well, who do you like? Dr. Stafford is available today, super understanding, and girl, he has seen way worse. Thanks, Rash.
You've got more options than you know. Book now.
EGO, the number one rated brand in cordless outdoor power, brings you the Select Cut Mower. Customize the cut with three interchangeable blades. It cuts for over an hour on a single charge. EGO, exclusively at Lowe's, Ace, and EGO authorized dealers.
Good morning. But I'm ready to burn. Super hot fire when I move, better feel that burn. Get up before the sun is up, baby, let's work. Good morning. Ready or not, here I come, let's work. Good morning. Get up before the sun is up, baby, let's work. Baby, let's work.
Experience Tommy John Second Skin. Let's work.
'61-54, Bradley the lead with 3:47 to go in the first round of the NIT, and it's bracket time. Download the ESPN Tournament Challenge app to fill out your men's and women's brackets. I'm sure you've already done this. We are doing this as well. Scott Williams, who are your final four picks?
Well, I like the red hot Iowa State team right now. Of course, my North Carolina Tar Heels. I like Houston's defense and Tennessee to make the Final Four, with North Carolina and Houston meeting in the championship game, and my Tar Heels taking home yet another national championship title.
I love it. You got to pick your school. I mean, it's also, when you went to North Carolina, I think it's pretty easy to pick your school most years, right?
Well, they have been good all year long, especially the last 6 weeks. Two big wins over Duke.
Well, here are my picks, and feel free to not pick any of these because it's probably going to be wrong. But I did pick Duke, and this was not a shot at you. This was me scrambling to make my picks before we started the show.
Well, I'm going to let it go right now because we got such a good game going, but we're going to talk about that after the basketball game, putting Duke in that Final Four and leaving my Tar Heels out.
Yeah, I'm nervous for that talk. Now in the corner, three ball is good for Braden Norris.
Now, you talked about how they were going to need Norris down the stretch if they were going to have any chance to win this game, and he comes off that pine with that foul difficulty and knocks down a quick triple.
Alibi Leons finding Darius Hanna with 3:15 to go. And a nice pass underneath, and Duke Dean will put it in.
Got caught ball watching, and his guy went back door for the easy bucket. Cook Valentine's head just dropped to his chest.
8-point lead now, and Norris in the paint scores on the foul. Loyola not going away.
That son of a coach, the fifth year grad student. We talked about the love that Coach Valentine has for this kid. He is just so gutty now. 16 points on the night. Tell me he doesn't want to play one more game after this. Fighting hard to try to come back and get this victory.
Braden Norris with all 16 of those points coming in the second half tonight.
It was a 5-point game with this big free throw here.
There it is.
Well, lot of time left. 3 minutes is an eternity in basketball.
Bradley with a 5-point lead with under 3 minutes to go in the 71st all-time meeting between these longtime rivals in a series that dates back to 1926.
And Loyola just keeps fighting. You know, 21, they chip it down to 10, and then Bradley puts it back to 14. They get it down to 4, and then they put it back to 9. Now it's at 5 again. So they just keep coming. 5 to shoot.
3 seconds to shoot. 2. Do they know it? Davis at 3. End of the shot clock. No. Rebound ripped down by Mwamba.
Great stop by Loyola. That's what you want, a big man shooting a shot that he's not comfortable taking.
Jalen Quinn firing it towards the basket and a foul called. Darius Hanna called for the foul.
I think Hanna was in real good defensive position there, but he just reached down at that basketball trying to slap it away. I don't know what the smaller player was going to do against him anyway. I just needed to stay high. Now let the Ramblers have a chance to score from the free throw line with that game clock stopped.
So Jalen Quinn now to the free throw line. He's been a good free throw shooter. Well, the Ramblers have left some points on the board, and they leave another one.
Oh, possibility for 2 big points. They could have made it a single possession game.
Loyola now 10 out of 17. Quinn the steal. Quinn, no. Rebound, Hanna.
Oh, he tried to challenge Hanna, maybe try to get to the free throw line. He probably been better served to circle back out. A lot of time left in this game. No need to panic.
Under 2 minutes.
Again, Bradley taking some time off of that game clock.
Darius Hanna with 5 to shoot, down to 3 to shoot, 2 to shoot, end of the clock, puts it in.
Are you kidding me with that English off the backboard? He spun it in without even looking at the hoop.
Timeout taken by Braden Norris and Loyola Chicago. Bradley has the lead back up to 7 with 89 seconds to go in regulation at Carver Arena.
You know, Hanna, last time he had the ball with the shot clock running down, he settled for the triple. This time he said, oh no, I'm going to my strength, I'm going inside, and kind of looking back over his right shoulder, maybe caught a little piece of the rim out of the corner of his eye, and he was able to put that thing in off the glass. What a play by that young man.
Great play from Darius Hanna. You take a look now at the timeout situation. Bradley still has 2, Loyola with 1 left, neither team with a foul to give. And now you look at our bracket, and again, whoever wins this tonight will play the winner of our later game, which is starting just about now, Cincinnati and San Francisco in the Queen City. And so we'll see how that one shakes out. But Indiana State playing SMU tonight. We know that Minnesota has already advanced with a 1-point win over 4-seed Butler. And again, you can watch all these games on the ESPN app. It's been a real exciting game tonight. It has been a very odd game tonight, too.
Yeah.
When you say, Scott, I mean, the first
half, bizarre.
It was 10-0 Bradley. They're blowing Loyola out. It's a 21-point game. Loyola gets it to 4, and now Bradley is up 7, but even that feels tenuous. The timeout, Alston, no. Tipped back to Adelakun, and Norris has got it. Greg Dolan with a good look from 3. Misses there, hand of the rebound. And now a whistle with 1:11 to go, and Bradley takes a timeout.
Yeah, I don't think they liked where their guards were in relation to their big guys. They didn't want Hanna getting fouled and have to go to the line and shoot some free throws. So smart play taking that timeout. They can get their good free throw shooters back in this basketball game. Well, when they've needed big boards, whether it be on the offensive end or the defensive end, it's been Hanna or Leons controlling that glass. And you can see right there, they just said, hey, let's just call timeout. Let's get the ball into the hands of our free throw shooters here and see if we can either burn some time off of that clock with only 1:11 to play, or make them put us at the line and we get a high percentage free throw shooter on that free throw line.
But Scott, right now with 1:11 to go, Loyola has been playing all this time with Alston and Norris with four fouls. Rubin has three. Bradley does not have the same foul trouble. Hickman's got three. But yeah, over the next minute 11, that's going to be huge because certainly, if nothing else, Loyola wants Norris taking any free throws here.
Yeah, and they got Norris out of this basketball game. In case they got a foul quickly, then he's not getting his fifth foul because they need his three-point shooting down the stretch.
They beat the pressure. Duke Dean, ahead for Hannah!
I would have never thought you'd throw an alley-oop from 45 feet away in that type of situation, but boy, Dean delivers a strike and Hannah flushed it home.
And now a three off target from Mwamba. And Darius Hannah with the exclamation point that may just send Bradley on to round two. Davis, yes, it's an 11-point game with 40.8 left.
Oh, Bradley with two big stops and two big buckets to end the basketball game. And then racing it down the other way. No quitting the Ramblers. They get a glaying off the glass, and Coach Valentine snatches a timeout. But look at this one more time. He threw that from darn near half court for the alley-oop. Thing of beauty by Dean to Hannah for the jam, putting the cap on this basketball game. And I love this one more time. He just goes right in there. Game clock be darned. I'm going to take it to the bucket and get us a couple more points.
Well, the Bradley Braves, to their credit, when it gets down to four, when you're up 21, you could easily panic and give up the lead. They never gave up the lead. They have led the entire basketball game tonight, and they're now 36.3 seconds away from eliminating their in-state rivals in Loyola and moving on to round two of the NIT.
Yeah, and with that last lay in there, Bradley got to that 70 point, make it 71 points, and we talked about that being the key number for the Braves. They're 19-4 this season when they score 70 points or more, and even last season they were 19-1 when they scored 70 or more.
Yep, and the winner of this game will take on the winner of San Francisco and Cincinnati, which is currently underway on ESPN Plus, so you can check that game out once this one concludes. But a 9-point Bradley lead, and Darius Hannah can't help but smile after that thunderous alley-oop slam off the near half-court feed from Duke Dean, which appears to have put Bradley into round two. Baseball passed down the floor, and Dean is fouled by Dolan with 34.7. And you look at the totality of this game, and it's clear that Loyola deserves credit too. Listen, this has not been their best game. They have not led in this game, but Bradley took it to them early. Loyola could have easily folded in this. They got it down to a 4-point game. They went on an incredible second half run.
Yeah, 43 points.
And it appears though, Scott, in the end, that Bradley's ability to jump out early just created so much friction for Loyola to try to claw their way back. It's just been insurmountable.
Yeah, they're very, very good when they have the lead at halftime. And it got a little shaky there. We mentioned that Loyola with his 43 points in the second half, but they've done just enough down the stretch with these offensive rebound possessions and making their free throws to just keep the Ramblers away from winning this basketball game.
Here's Phillip Alston for three. That won't go. A foul. It's going the other way.
Yeah, got Dolan underneath, grabbing on there, trying to get that rebound. But that's what you got to do. You got to try to fight for that and get that ball and stop that game clock without any extra ticks coming off on the missed shot. But, boys, I tell you what, I'm going to give Coach Valentine and his crew a lot of credit in this second half. But Bradley was just too good tonight. They executed their offense and their defense, especially in that first half, holding Loyola just 19 points to start this game. Good look at Coach Wardle right there. I talked about the intensity they had in practice yesterday. They wanted this win tonight.
And now Connor Hickman at the free throw line, trying to ice this game away, misses the free throw, but still an 11-point lead for Bradley with 23.7 seconds to go. The Bradley Braves about to win their 16th straight game against teams in the state of Illinois.
That's impressive.
And they will move to 19-3 in their last 22. Those only three losses came to Loyola when they were still in the Missouri Valley Conference. You heard the Bradley fans chanting MVC. I think that their message was received. Shot clock is off. Brayden Norris misses the three. The rebound to Hannah. And the Bradley Braves can dribble it out. Bradley's going on to round two of the National Invitation Tournament. 74-62, they knock out their in-state rivals.
Well, hard-fought game. Like you say, the tale of two halves. Loyola showed a lot of fight coming back and making this a two-possession game. But at the end, Bradley did not splinter. They buckled a little bit, but they did not break, and they get the victory and will move on to the next round.
So Loyola's season comes to an end. They finish 23-10. And Bradley moving on. They are now 23-11 overall. So you see it. Bradley will move on to round two. They'll play Saturday or Sunday. We will figure out who they will play and where they will play after Cincinnati and San Francisco. That game is currently on ESPN Plus, so we hope you will tune in for that so you can figure out who is going to play Bradley in round two of the NIT. But a very good performance from the Bradley Braves tonight, and they're moving on. Kaboom is thrilled, and so are the people down here in Peoria. So for Scott Williams and our entire crew, my name is Jordan Burnfield. Thanking you so much for joining us tonight. The Bradley Braves knocked Loyola out of the NIT, and they're moving on to round number two. 74-62, the final. Good night from Peoria.
The future is threatened. By enemies often, unseen. When there are battles to win for America's future, there is one constant, Marines.
Gatorade Zero. Zero sugar hydration with all the flavor and electrolytes of Gatorade. Hydration for every athlete, forever.
And since I get 5% off every day with the Milo's Rewards credit card, we could get it today. No way.